I'm Bruce McAvaney, and joining me today is Mark Bredda. Welcome to our viewers to the Den Racecourse for today's Cougar A Grade and A Reserves Premiership Side Horse Race, a race which stops the club rooms. These past and present horses will determine who is the best and fairest of them all. Looks big in prime conditions, eh, Bretts?
Superb, Bruce. The course has been maintained beautifully with the great rainfall over the past few weeks. We can see here the race officials have been busy organising the event with most important signage and a brand new entrance.
Race official, the very talented and super sophisticated Tracy Darlitz, looks to be warming up for the race ahead and testing her powerful starting gun.
Just showing footage of a very important person, Julie Will, caretaker and manager to these horses, and an essential part of ensuring the day runs smoothly as she prepares the horses and tends to their every last need.
Passing down to the stables, where horses seem to be undertaking their practice routine, we can see Jules working hard in the background preparing these horses for what will be one of the most intense races this sport has seen.
Yeah, we can see here, Bruce, Julie giving horses a last minute rub down. For our viewers watching, we'd just like to give you insight into the strict training regimes these horses have been undergoing. We can see here each horse is in full flight preparing for the big race.
First up, we can see horse Jos Phelps. Josie runs a speedy race and loves to shoot. Unique to her is her flicking shooting style, one to watch out for.
Here we have Robin May, renowned for her long plaited hair. Bruce, she's the oldest horse on the track by a long mile. She's a gutsy, determined, fierce competitor who hopes to lose. I'd be watching out for her bumming action as she demands to get in front position.
Karen Green, a beautiful looking and placid horse, comes across quite shy, but her speed and steadiness could put her in good stead. I'm tipping her as a dark horse for today.
A wonderful horse this next horse, Celia Micken, the youngest of all the premiership horses and still going strong today. Rumour has it, Bruce, she has been racing alongside many of these horses racing today's offspring and is continuing to show them up. Determined, fit and can provide plenty of drive, she'll be a real contestant. We can see here Karen and Celia being quite friendly at the stables.
A fine and stubborn horse that can prove quite difficult to her trainer. Can see her here, Barrettes, in her trademark colours, a hat and sunnies. She's been on a strict diet of West End and Durries for today's race, in sensational condition. Sorry, Barrettes, just getting live news that three, not just one, but three horses have been scratched from the race. Melissa Seeger, a very fine looking horse, due to give foal to twin fillies. Sam Pedler, too busy dancing up a storm at the Den and distracted by her witty stallion. Shad Letton, refusing to load into the horse's float due to having too good of a time on the mantelpiece and figuring out how to remove her rug. Her jockey, Jim Bob, would be shattered not to get in to ride her today.
What a shame! Fortunate for the other horses, however, Bruce. Here we have Stephanie Phelps, an exceptionally talented horse winning many best and fairest, along with being state higher and long jumper, quite timid and could possibly jump her way to the finish line.
Our last horse of the day, Marty Green. Well known for giggling and may not get far due to her proneness of stumbling and rolling on the course. Loves a good backstretch.
I know, what else could possibly go wrong? Darlitz is seeking medical attention from Julie due to too much trigger pulling on the gun. What a disaster! Will this race ever go ahead?
Darlitz giving final checkups to the horses at the barriers. We can see front of the barriers as well as behind. Not long before the race begins, Brett, I can't wait.
And they're off! They all look to be keeping up with one another. It's going to be a close race, I think, Bruce, except for Glover. She's refused to leave the barrier. Green looks to be nudging towards May. This could mean something. I thought it might. She's giving May a knock. May has whipped back. They look like they want the same thing. May and Green both knocking one another in a tight contest. May giving a quick little bump, and they've tumbled. They're both out. Shattering.
May looks to be getting back up, Brett. Hopefully no legs are broken. Jules appears to be charging to the rescue. Green giggling her way out of misery, and May absolutely shattered and not happy at all. Glover, she appears to have moved from the barrier, casually strutting her stuff and taking a drinks break, not happy with the options race has provided. She seeks alternate solutions in a light bulb moment and decides to finish the race in a quicker way.
She takes out Josie Phelps, speeds up and on her way, she three knocks over Karen Green, Steph Phelps, and she does it! Knocks the youngest horse on the field and arrogantly struts herself to the finish line. She can see the prize in sight, a cold, well-earned red tin, possibly still a bit tipsy from her pre-race routine, attempting to open the esky lid from the wrong side.
Oh, Barrett, what a race. Rox will enjoy that cold and well-deserved beer in an outstanding victory. An incredible race. The other horses were outdone by Rox's strategic race plan.
The celebrations will go long and hard into the night, I reckon, Bruce. A great snapshot of some of the most brilliant horses this club room has ever seen. An absolute privilege to be sitting in the chair commentating today's race alongside you, Bruce.
Likewise, Barrett. We will see you here next year in the hot seat again.